The clearance operation in Marte was successfully completed on Wednesday last week, less than 48 hours after the Chief of Army Staff's marching orders. The success was recorded on the same day insurgents fired mortar bombs into the capital city, killing 10 and leaving at least 50 people injured. Over 35,000 people fled from Marte to Dikwa, following indications that the attackers were winning. The Borno State Governor, Professor Babagana Zulum, arrives Dikwa a day after the military announced that it had retaken Marte and remains there the whole weekend to build the confidence of the people. Governor Zulum has been talking to the affected population, calling on citizens to brace up and be resilient.
We must be resilient enough. Otherwise, the entire state will be displaced. The recent attack will not deter this administration at all in ensuring establishment of civil authorities in respective LGS, in ensuring rehabilitation, resettlement, and the construction of the displaced communities in Borno State.
The local people have sad stories to tell, but are nonetheless homesick. They were only resettled in Marte last December, after 4 years in Maiduguri.
Security shike suna mu gargadi to don sun ko yauke muka gantsu gan ba abun da zai samu mu yarda da su tare da muke zama amma su bawo kam da mutane wadansu zukiyan shi ya zauna ma wadansu ba su da zukiya suna so su vita shine abun da ya sa an kale mu duka ya yashe.
The people are eager to return, but the military have bad news for the people. The roads are now laden with explosives.
There are some IEDs that were being mounted there. Maybe if they clear all the IEDs, then he is going to allow all the IDPs to go back there.
Some 1,000 persons also fleeing from Marte had also proceeded to Ngala, where they have found refuge. The federal government, through the Ministry of Humanitarian Affairs, has responded by supporting the Borno State government with food and non-food items for the affected population.